Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about how to study pharmacology effectively. And I think this is a very important topic because pharmacology is a very important topic. I think, honestly, probably one of the most important topics, whether you're in pharmacy, nursing, or handling any kind of medications like in medicine or even like dentistry, because it can basically explain to you how drugs actually affect patients or how the drug actually works in the patient, as well as why patients may be having side effects based on the drugs. So let's get right into this video. So first things first, when you're studying pharmacology, it's very important to understand what is pharmacology. And basically it's the study of the drugs and their effects. So when I think of pharmacology, I like to think of two different categories, mainly pharmacokinetics or PK, and then pharmacodynamics or PD. So pharmacokinetics is basically the study of how the body affects the drug. And this could be summarized into the absorption, the metabolism, the distribution, and the elimination. And then pharmacodynamics is basically how the drug affects the body. And this is usually seen in like mechanism of action or adverse effects. I like to have specific categories on top of that. So I like to also have categories for like indication. I like to have categories as well for drug-drug interactions, and then a category for contraindications on top of adverse effects. So now that you have all the categories, you can basically put like each individual drug into each category, and you can basically like write out each one, but obviously it's gonna take a very, very long amount of time. So now we're gonna talk about how to actually effectively study pharmacology so that way you can actually learn and memorize things a lot better and a lot faster. So now we can talk about how to actually study effectively. So first things first, what you wanna do when you're studying is that you actually wanna study based on the specific class. So one example of that is like hypertension. So what you can do is you can actually study like ACE inhibitors or angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors versus ARBs, which are angiotensin receptor blockers. And now that actually makes it a lot easier to study based on their mechanism of action. And what makes it also very easy to study them is because most of them have the same suffix or prefix. So for example, the ACE inhibitors all have the same suffix of pril versus the ARBs have the same suffix of arten. So now you can literally like learn most of the drugs right there just because they have the same mechanism of action and they have the same suffix. And that's a couple of drugs right there that you memorize very quickly. So once you actually study the entire class, now you can look for very specific things that actually differentiates them in the class. For example, there could be some drugs that have things that make it like only used in certain patient populations. So for example, say a patient can only use it if they have good kidney function versus another drug which cannot be used in good kidney function. So now you can actually differentiate drugs based on specific things that make it different from the other drugs in the same class. And this can actually make your questions right there. So first you make questions on the entire class, and then you can make questions about specific drugs that you would utilize in certain patient populations based on difference about them, which is pretty cool. So one good example of that is like vancomycin. Like one drug that you can actually memorize, I always memorize, is because of Redman syndrome. And I memorize that drug just because of the fact that it has an adverse effect of causing Redman syndrome. So once you actually understand the class, you understand what makes it actually different is that it has a very, very rare side effect that no other drug usually has. And that makes it very easy to ask your question on tests, but it makes it very easy to memorize as well. So that's what you want to utilize when you're actually studying. Okay, so now that we have the basis of pharmacology, we have the basis of understanding how to study effectively using the classes and then looking for specific indications. Now we can actually go into Quizlet and I can show you guys how to use Quizlet so you can actually effectively study a lot better and make flashcards a lot faster. So for me, I like using Quizlet because I was constantly on the move. I was either studying at home or I was studying on the train or studying at work. And for me, I like Quizlet just because like I could actually download the actual slide deck and I could utilize that whenever I wanted to. Even if I had like a 5-minute break, I can go on my phone real quickly and do a couple of questions. So I really like that for that reasoning. And I'm also gonna show you some advanced features that I understood later on that actually allowed me to actually make the questions a lot better so that I can utilize Quizlet more when I actually was studying. So by now you guys probably know I love active recall questions, and basically it's when you ask yourself a question to actually recall the information. So what you would do when you make the question, you try to make the question so that the answer is the drug name. So here's a good example. What is a selective COX-2 inhibitor? And the answer will be Celebrex. That's kind of how I made every single flashcard from now on. I made them into questions and it had the drug name be the answer. So once you're actually able to make these active recall questions based on the classes and the different specific indications that are utilized and the adverse effects of the drugs, it just becomes a point of rinse and repeat. Like, you know, you gotta constantly just keep making more and more flashcards. Even if you have like 20 minutes, you gotta make like 5 or 6 flashcards right there and then keep on doing them. I think the most important thing for most people is that they think that they have to like burn through like 100 flashcards a day, and that's not the case. Like for me, I would just try to focus on just doing like 15, 20 flashcards sometimes, or even like 30 flashcards. Or even if you have just like 5 minutes, just like make 1 or 2 flashcards. And the most important thing is that you're doing them early and often throughout the time you're studying. So like as soon as you're like your first day, you should have some flashcards right there, and then you just keep adding on to the list. And it actually helps you study, because then you can see which ones you actually have more problems with, and then you can actually work on that later. Okay, so now let's get into the advanced tips for using Quizlet, because I think a lot of people need to start utilizing these tips, and a lot of these tips can actually help you a lot when you're making these flashcards. So the thing I like to utilize in Quizlet is the learn feature, and I like to set up so the options say multiple choice questions, because most of my exams were in multiple choice questions, so it just makes sense to study in that format. So once I did that, I would actually make the question, the term, and then the drug name, the definition. And it's very important when you're actually writing the definition out that you put the definition, spell it correctly. For example, vancomycin again. Vancomycin, if you spell it with a capital V and then make another question with the answer vancomycin with a lowercase v, sometimes the question would actually show up with both answer choices on multiple choice questions. So that's kind of a disservice to you, because when you're having a multiple choice question, you want to have 4 choices that are all different. So if you have 2 of them that are kind of the same, it kind of tells you the answer, as well as like kind of does the disservice to yourself, because you're not actually giving yourself the opportunity to mimic an actual exam. And obviously you're doing it yourself, so you can obviously say that's correct, but it's just better to just do it the way that it makes sense for a test. So every single answer choice that you put definition for, make sure that the answer choice is exactly the same written when it is the same answer. So that way when you ask the question, it'll actually, the computer will actually recognize that, and then you will have questions that have different answers every single time, which is very, very good. And over time, it becomes so much easier to do this, and it's actually very, very fun sometimes, in my opinion, to do this over just doing regular flashcards. And it actually will help you a lot when you're studying, because you're still recalling, you're making it very close to the actual exam, and on top of that, you're actually studying it in a way that actually will help you learn. And another thing that's very important too is that when I studied, I used to do it so that my test usually had about 15 to 20 pharmacology questions. So I would usually study in like 15 to 20 increments of pharmacology. And then on top of that, like say for example, I want to study a little bit more, then I can obviously do 50 or 60 flashcard multiple choice questions on top. But 15 to 20 was like a good number for me, because it actually mimicked my actual exam, and then I can see what questions I actually got wrong, and actually I can actually go back to it. So when you're actually able to go back to it, it's very important that you just follow the same concept like I said before of writing the drug out by itself and then filling in the exact categories like we talked about before. So like, for example, I remember in oncology, I had a big issue with like memorizing some of the drugs because there's just like so much information. So some of the drugs that I didn't really get to recall very well, I would actually list it out based on like mechanism of action, indication, drug-drug interactions, adverse effects, and contraindications. I actually wrote out each one for some of them, which helped me out a lot, because then we're actually able to visualize it on the actual paper, then you can actually see some of the differences as opposed to just constantly trying to get the question right and you're not getting it right. So that way you can actually focus on understanding what you're actually doing to actually learn it better. Okay, so the final tip is gonna be to actually create folders. And this is something that I think is very important, because when you're doing all these flashcards, you're gonna easily make over 100, 200 flashcards per class, and that's a lot of flashcards. And also on top of that, sometimes the questions are sometimes hard to actually always have this format of the question being the term and the answer being definition of the drug. So those cases where you actually wanna have a little bit more fleshed out answer or have a different question set, you make a different folder so that way you can study those things differently than the regular questions that you had previously. Because with this learn feature, it makes it so that these questions have the same format. So let's say if the answer will be the drug, Say, for example, you don't want to put the answer as a drug and say you want to have it the reverse, then it'll make no sense to have it in this format. So it's very important to make folders so that way, like, when you choose to like do a different method outside of it and have like a different flashcard set, then you can actually do that separately. And it's very important, I remember, and from my example, I remember when I was in infectious diseases and I couldn't memorize any of the actual drugs because all the drugs had like 2-3 drug combinations, and I couldn't obviously put it with my pharmacology set because those are different sets, you know? So for me, I had to make a different folder just for the brand name and generics of the infectious disease drugs. And then I made a different set for the pharmacology stuff so that way I can easily organize it and still focus me on topic when I was doing my work. So yeah, that's pretty much what I had to do. And that's very important for your studying because over time you're gonna be doing over like 100, 200 flashcards per class. So it's very important you have these different folders and study sets in place so that you can study them effectively and actually organize your work so you can always go back to it if you need to. And if you need to study for, like, for example, NAPLEX, or if you have like a rotation where you have to pull up the material. So that's gonna be the end of the video for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This took a long time to actually improve and make this process very efficient. So yeah, I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out. Bye.